15 years ago, in one of the world leading human robotics research centers, we've noticed that prosthetic feet were just not yet able to mimic intact ankle behavior. And the weird thing is that the whole world seems to think that things just can't be better. So we started studying human biomechanics and doing research in robotics in order to solve this problem. And our findings were very interesting. My name is Pierre Cherelle. I'm a physicist, PhD in robotics engineering, and founder CEO of Axiles Bionics. Axiles Bionics is a spin-off from Robotics. We are specialized in robotics, artificial intelligence, and human biomechanics. And our aim is to improve the quality of life with assistive robotics. Our first focus today is with lower limb amputees and bringing the next generation bionic devices to the market. Over the years, we've made significant breakthroughs, which led to the creation of Axiles Bionics. And today, I'd like to present you three core innovations that we are implementing in our technology. The first one is what I call biomechanical compliant actuation. In order for a robot to move, it requires to have muscles, such as a human. Now, in terms of engineering, the choice of components is rather simple. You can either have springs in which energy is stored and released. You can have dampers in which energy is being dissipated forever. Or you can choose for motors in which energy will be generated. It also makes sense to analyze human biomechanics. If you look at a knee, for example, you will see that a lot of energy is being dissipated during walking. Therefore, it makes a lot of sense to use dampers in prosthetic knees. However, using the same technology in prosthetic ankles just doesn't make scientific sense. Because actually, an ankle generates a lot of energy during walking. The shortcut would be thinking to use a motor. But there again, the problem is the amount of energy is so big that you would end up with a motor that weighs 4 to 5 kilograms. This is obviously not an option for a prosthetic device. The solution was found in research a number of years ago and is called compliant actuation. It is the combination of using springs together with motors. And this is kind of like in the analogy to use a bow and arrow compared to throwing a spear by hand. And by the way, the human muscles are also a kind of compliant actuation. But that's not everything. There is still a challenge. They still require a lot of energy, which means big batteries. And when those batteries are depleted, you end up with a device that is heavy and non-functional. So we understood that very early in the process, and we noticed that the sweet spot was in combining compliant actuation for its flexibility, safety, and assistance, together with bio-inspired mechanics that will ensure a biomechanical functioning at all times. This is, in our opinion, what will make the difference in hardware in the next generation bionic devices. The second topic I'd like to talk about relates to artificial intelligence. When we walk, we sense our environment, and our brain sends commands to the body to move accordingly. Well, a robot also needs some sort of intelligence, and the prosthesis is not able yet to sense its environment. So the way this is generally done is by doing complex physics modeling of the environment, of the human, of the robot. Also adding complex control algorithms. The thing is, this works quite well in the lab and with a specific person. But as soon as we're getting outside of the lab, these kind of modeling techniques completely fail. This is also why, for example, bipedal robots, it's so difficult to make them walk like humans. The solution here is the use of artificial intelligence, and more precisely, deep learning. But what is deep learning? Deep learning is a subset of machine learning, and machine learning on its turn is a subset of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is a technique that enables a machine to behave like a human. Machine learning is a technique to enable artificial intelligence through gathering and training of data. And deep learning is a special type of machine learning in which uses the structure of the human brain. The principle is rather simple. If you have both input and output data, and you have sufficient of those, then you can train what we call an artificial neural network to make links among themselves. The more data you have, the more, the better these links become, the more precise the links become, and therefore the more precise the system becomes. We've implemented this in the bionic foot by actually first making a brace that is instrumented like our bionic technology. With this brace, we are capable of measuring both input and output data on healthy individuals. After that, when training the neural network, we are capable of embedding it, the intelligence, into the bionic foot, which enables it to detect different activities very precisely, such as walking, stair climbing, standing, sitting, and so on. The third topic I'd like to talk about also relates to artificial intelligence and to a major problem of today's prosthetics, is the fact that today people still need to adapt to their prostheses, while it actually should be the opposite. Everyone walks and acts differently, everybody's gait is different. So why are prosthetics not adapting to the user? The field of AI that copes with this problem is called reinforcement learning. The principle behind is that you have what we call an agent, in this case it's the bionic device. You will leave the possibility to this agent to take actions and to explore the environment, and by observing what's happening and getting rewards, it will actually become self-learning. You can think of it like a human in a maze that needs to find its way out. You will have to explore, try, and be rewarded by choosing the right path. This technique has already been implemented in applications which are very difficult and actually impossible to model with regular physics. Think of it like, for example, a ping pong robot that needs to play like a human against a human, or a robotic hand that needs to learn have the right dexterity in order to solve a Rubik's Cube. These are the types of problems that can be solved by reinforcement learning. And the more the robot plays ping pong, the more the robotic hand moves the Rubik's Cube in its fingers, the better it becomes. Such as a human, the more it does a certain action, the more precise that action becomes, the better he becomes doing that action. At Axiles Bionics, our aim is to relieve people from physical limitations. We are convinced that these new technologies will revolutionize prosthetics in the next coming years. Our goal is to bring peace of mind and body to both end user as healthcare professionals with innovative bionic solutions, artificial intelligence, and outstanding services. Thank you very much for your attention.